Okay, my talk is about working on TK, especially on the TK core. TK core is not like an extension. You have to get some motivation to do it because it's a long time work. I had started with making some enhancements, and then I added additional functionality to TK widgets. Currently, I'm including new widgets in TK, and I also have some further ideas. These ideas are open to discussion, and then some conclusions. Yeah, let's start with motivation. I've used Tickle TK since some years, maybe over 10 years now. And I currently use it in our simulator. All the graphical user interface for the simulator for the instructors is built with Tickle TK. And this year in our company, we started long time support. That means our power plant is running 40 years, and we now have a policy to prepare for 60 years plus. So all the applications are evaluated, and we look to make them available also in the future. So I think I need long time support for my applications, and I will start to use extensions I currently use to put it in the TK core. I added missing functionality and also new widget types. Okay, let's go. So, start with enhancements. Since some years, I have an own extension. It's a Tickle-only extension for objects. There I had private variables. Thanks to Donald, maybe I can remove this part. It's now in the Tickle core. Then I started on TK with displaying text in progress bars. You have an example here. And the last one in the enhancements was displaying additional hints in entries, spin box, and combo box widgets. You can find it also now in the TK87, is it? In TK86, I don't know. I added an additional functionality because I think we have problems in high-resolution devices with using images. And I found in library, it's a header-only library, Nano SVG, and it's possible to use it from TCL, from TK. It was the first work was done by Christian Golbitzer. But I think it would be also a nice addition to the TK core, and maybe Christian Werner could benefit from this part because you don't have to provide different images. He can scale images. I have here, it's available currently in the TIP 507. And if you have an image, you can with simple comments display this image. You can use it as a normal TK image, and you can scale it and do some transformations with it. Limited is it. The library is limited because we don't have currently text to display. The text feature is not included. Maybe we can add some fonts, but the font handling will blow it up, and I think for displaying simple SVG elements or images, it's enough. My current work is adding additional widgets. I use in my work in the company the RBC toolkit. RBC was a rewrite from the original BLT from George Hollett. Currently, there is no active development on RBC. We have already stolen the RBC buzzy command. It's currently TK Buzzy in TK. I use from RBC currently the RBC vector and RBC graph command. The RBC is currently in the TK core on the TIP 510. Oh, it's a typo here. It's in separately directories inside the TK core, and the commands are residing in the RBC namespace. In this namespace, we have the vector, the graph, the bar chart, and the zip plot command. All the code inside is prefixed with RBC, and I have done some code cleanup, have removed unnecessary code. Yes. An additional command is the RBC winop snap. You can snap in widget and create an image from it. And I have removed this code in TK in the TK command. So you can do a TK snap like a TK buzzy. You can do a TK snap with in widget, and you get an image back. All the old RBC tests, mostly passing. There are some formatting issues still. I have added existing man pages, and I've had also added a new markdown documentation. You can find this documentation online if you go in the timeline on the TK core and go in the doc directory in the RBC, and then you find a markdown file, and you can display it in your browser online. So no need to convert something. Maybe this is also a possibility to put all the TK documentation in Markdown and put it in the on the server, and you get a free online documentation for this. The only problem open here in RBC is we don't have any Mac support. I don't have a Mac myself, and maybe some people haven't and can give me a hand in supporting this. That's an example from my usage of RBC. You have two different XY axes, and you can display in a limited number of curves, and you have different axes, and it's a really nice graph widget, I think. Let's go into the future. My next task is to add TK paths to the TK core. We already have heard about it today. TKPath also has no active development. It has canvas and SVG elements inside. So you can run the same code you have for a canvas, you can also run for a TKPath. And it has additional SVG elements. With these elements, you get scaling, rotation, grouping, use of true type fonts for free. No additional source code is needed for you from you. Currently, it uses for display Cairo on X, and uses GDE Plus on Windows 32 and on the Mac. I don't know. And on the Androidish, it uses Egg and SDL. I currently use it for soft panels, for drawings, for function plans, and special displays. The code I am currently using, the TK path code I'm currently using, I have put on ChiselApp, so you can check it out. And added to the original version from TK path was PDF output via PDF for Tickle. Before I start, I would like to have your opinion about some questions. The first one is, should we use a separate namespace for the command? It's mostly only the TK path. It's called currently TKP canvas. Maybe we can call it TK path or something else. Then should it also go in separate directories like TTK and RBC? And the next one is also a little bit tricky because we have the old canvas elements in TK path, and these elements don't support rotating and scaling so easily like the SVG elements. And if you mix elements from canvas and from SVG, you still get some problems with scaling, for example. So it could be possible to remove these elements, and if some people are using canvas, he can still using the old canvas, and if they are using SVG, they can use a new TK path. We don't have any PostScript output here. As mentioned before, we have PDF generation, and we create PDF with VR PDF for TK. These are some examples from TK path. It's all a canvas widget, a TK path canvas widget. We have some drawings. We have a panel with thousands of elements. All these elements are animated. We have on bigger panels, we have over 1,000 variables attached to this panel, and they to dynamically change the position of the meters or the displays of the lamps. And we have an core display. There are, I don't know, some thousand variables, and each cell has a value behind, and it changes the color depending on the value. Now some further ideas. The first one is I have worked with TK, and I found out that we have option handling in TK with an two-step mode. We define an option specification there, and then we create for each widget we are using an option object, and promote the option specification inside this object, and then we can work with it. So my idea is to expose this AP as an TKL IP, and put each option in an array value. So we can work on from TKL with these options, and we can work from the other side from the C code with these options. And you get if you want to extend an existing widget, you just have to add an additional option in this array, and you are done with it. You don't have to wrap widgets or make some code for this. And currently we are using in TK an option database. It's modeled after X11, I think. But I don't know, is anyone using these?
Old
code. Yeah, I think it's still some old code, and nobody really using it. Maybe we can put an SQLite inside and put this code in SQLite, and we could go even further and maybe put even the TTK options inside it. Make it some special one. It's called theme option also, and it's not setable from the widget, but it's only setable from the theme. And we can promote the changes to the widgets. It's still open, and just some ideas here. Then I think it would be nice to have a 3D widget in TK. And we could also use a PDF output we are currently using in TK path for other widgets to create code from him. So let's have a look. No. So I will show you some Some demonstration of the used widgets. Here we have the panel. Oops. That's our main control room here. We have some big side panels, and it exists in hardware and in our simulator, and we have also so-called soft panel simulators, like here. So you can have the simulator on screens. You don't need the hard panel. Kann man den wegmachen hier? Scheiße. Ach, scheiße. Ja. Okay, machen wir es. So, that's all TK paths. You get here some anti-aliasing you have shown. You can zoom in. And you can also, just a moment. We start the simulator. So we get some action. And we can do a razor here. So we shut down the simulator, the plant. And to get the curves, here is the usage of the RBC widget. Oops. Our simulator.
So
yeah, it's live.
Rocks don't itself.
No. Yeah, it's. So you can see here we have an archive behind, so we get all the values from before. This is the graph widget. You have the axis. You can go with a mouse wheel and can change it. You can move it for everyone. So and here you see the usage of the TK Nano SVG. This is an online created SVG image. And if I change here something, maybe the style, then it will create it with a new definition. I've done, that was also the reason to use the TK SVG Nano, because you cannot provide so much different widgets for your application. So that now it's simple. It's a simple procedure. You have a template with a SVG code, and then you change the color or the style of the lines. Okay. Where's my? Ooh. Some conclusions. In my opinion, we have many hidden goodies in TK extensions, and we should include these goodies in TK main. Documentation is often tricky. I've started with NROF, and I think for new documentation, we could use an NROF editor, maybe. And we have, I found out that we often redefine float and mathematical function and macros in extensions and even in TK. We have it in TCL, but we don't redefine it in TK. Maybe we could put or we could extend the provided function and macros in TCL. That's it. Any questions?
So, my fun question is there any fundamental problem about adding the PostScript output to TKPath? It seems like it's the only one thing that spots out that we say that it's always said TKPath doesn't support. is it so complicated to edit, or is it?
It could be done. It's some work. But I think doing it for canvas elements, yeah, it's easy. But doing it for SVG elements, it's not so easy, I think.
Okay, so there is it's not just one thing. That's just
to provide it for all elements, it's a bigger task, I think. Yeah. And so I don't think it's a benefit for
it. So it could be added for the standards, for the canvas paths, and then it could be indeed a drop-in replacement for the canvas. It just wouldn't do the extra parts of picker path.
Yeah, but I already mentioned you get some unexpected behavior. If you the SVG started from a root element, and it has and each element has a transformation matrix. You can rotate it, you can flip it, and other things. You can scale it. And if you scale, for example, the matrix, the old canvas elements still remain the same.
Okay.
So, and also, if you use the scale command, the elements scale, but differently, and it's not so easy, I think. And I have used in my applications only the root element, and have an scaling command used in an external scaling command to change these matrix.
My thoughts were in that direction, that if we want TKP, if we could have TKPF as a relic drop-in replacement, that would do everything canvas does, plus maybe separately does other stuff. It doesn't, maybe the requirement wouldn't be that it mixes perfectly. It's just it can do exactly, it can mimic the canvas with whatever features the canvas currently has, and then it has separate features that would, from my opinion, define drop-in replacement.
Yeah, I will tip it, and then you can make some suggestions. Okay?
It is something like this, one user mode that it will just be drop-in replacement, and one user mode
that's
entirely compatible with it.
I think one problem with PostScript is that PostScript does, as far as I know, not have an alpha channel, but a PDF has.
That was a problem.
It's 10 years older than PDF, and the alpha channel in PDF is, it's not symmetric to the RGB of PDF. So you do have in PDF some, let's say, development, which you can see in the interface. So maybe PostScript is nice to have it directly on your printer, but which printer natively talks PostScript?
Nobody these days. If you can have PDF, you don't need PostScript.
So that's the point. So maybe we should drop PostScript support
in
favor of PDF.
Yes.
To see the power of PDF, I just have created an TK path with all the existing symbols in my application, and I can create from this TK path an PDF, and then I get an 200 pages PDF documentation of my used symbols with all the usage of these symbols. Let's have a look. Who is this then? Here. That was online. Now. Here. Here's the usage of this element, and that's the element. Just to show you performance. And it's not not optimized, because we go between TCL and PDF for Tickle to the TK path and back.
interrupt directly the discussion, but as I see there are no further questions, so we should now thank René for his